have worked on a project with Aboriginal people in Australia, and what the Aboriginal people told us is that through this exercise they reconnected to their land, and it is the first time in many years that they worked together, that they talked about issues which in their mind were banned from being talked about. And people get very excited. I always say people don't go for dinner, they don't go for lunch, because they are so excited to discover that they know, and that what they know is important for them and for the community. So there is an excitement, it's discovery learning, okay? So this is why I always say the mapping process is not a process which is meant to generate a map. It's an empowering process. It's completely different from any other participatory mapping exercise. The outcomes are pieces of art. I mean, this is if you look at this map, for example, this was produced by pygmies in the deep forest of Gabon. And what the chief said, it is on record, is that they proved to be human. Because unfortunately, pygmies in Central Africa are considered not at the same level as other people, proved to be humans, and this was another very touching statement. This is a beautiful map done in recently in the Democratic Republic of Congo. Again, a 3D map of a catchment area with all agricultural land users and so on. These kind of tools are tools which allows people to plan, which allows people to store their information, to pass it over to the younger generations, okay? And now a lot to deal with climate change adaptation.